private notice question, Mr. Gerald Kaufman.
Mr. Speaker, I beg to ask the Foreign and Commonwealth Secretary a question which I have given him private notice, namely, if he will make a statement about the diplomatic bags which have been lost in Wandsworth Prison.
Mr. Speaker, we learned some days ago that bags containing diplomatic mail, Canadian diplomatic mail, had been discovered by staff at Wandsworth Prison. Mr. Speaker, diplomatic bags are routinely sent to Wandsworth Prison for laundering. On this occasion, Mr. Speaker,
it's a Foreign Office brief. Come on.
Mr. Speaker, I must get the answer out. On this occasion, the Canadian bags in question had been inadvertently included in such a consignment sent to Wandsworth. Steps were immediately taken to recover the diplomatic mail and to investigate the incident.
Kaufman.
I'm sorry, Mr. Speaker, I hope there'd be more. Could the Honourable Gentleman explain why this question is not being answered by the Home Secretary? Yeah. On Monday...
Order! I remind the House, we have a very busy day ahead of us. This is going to take a lot of time.
On Monday... Dealing with one case, the Home Secretary hid behind his predecessor. On another case, he hid behind his legal advisers and a junior Home Office minister. Today, he is hiding behind the most junior available minister in another department. Will the Honourable Gentleman say what action has been taken to explain why the missing material was left in the bags sent to Wandsworth Prison? Will he explain exactly when it was discovered that this material was in the bags sent to Wandsworth Prison and when the search for it started? Is it true that an interval of several days elapsed between the discovery and the search? How much material is still missing? Is a search still going on for missing material? How much of this material, missing or retrieved, is sensitive material?
Well, order. Well, it's going to take a lot of time. I think the right honourable gentleman must get his question out.
Could the Honourable Gentleman say, if a watch was in the missing material, what guarantees? Yes.
Order. Order, please. Come on, Gerald.
What guarantees he can provide that other metal objects cannot find their ways into prison in the way that this did and disappear as this did? When was the Home Secretary informed about this latest episode? Why have the government not made this public, and would they have made it public if prison officers had not been aware of it? The Honourable Gentleman says that the government sent this material to be laundered.
Order. I think we're going to sit down. Well, I can't help if we don't sit down.
Is it going to send other material that it wants to launder to Wandsworth Prison? Or does it... Is the government now going to come clean about this episode?
Mr. Speaker, may I take the Right Honourable Gentleman's question seriously? Mr. Speaker, clearly this is a matter for the Foreign Office to... Mr. Speaker...
Order! I'm beginning to wonder whether I should have granted this private notice question.
Speaker, sir, your responsibility. There are 3 million people on the dole. This country is in a deep economic crisis. And this is on television. This is being shown on television, and it's a disgrace to the House.
Order. Let's get this over as quickly as we can.
Mr. Speaker, this is a private notice question tabled by the opposition, and the government has a duty and is... and I am here to answer it. If the House will give me an opportunity... Mr. Speaker, I think it is important. I'm sure the House will agree that it is important that I explain the background to the answer which I have previously given. And I'm sure the House will bear with me for 1 or 2 minutes while I explain what has happened on this occasion. And it is a serious matter. The position, Mr. Speaker, is this, that the Canadian government routinely sends their diplomatic bags to the Foreign Office for onward transmission.
May I say to the House that when I decided to grant this question, I judged it to be a serious matter, and I would like it taken seriously, please.
And on this occasion, some of their bags were contained in a white diplomatic bag belonging to the Foreign Office, which they were using for convenience to contain their consignment. And as I have explained to the House, that was the commencement of the error in question, which, of course, we very much regret. And, Mr. Speaker, I may say that I have come to the House this afternoon from a meeting with a representative of the Canadian High Commission, with whom we have been in constant touch throughout, from the outset of this incident, and I can say that they are perfectly satisfied with the outcome of the preliminary investigation which has taken place.
Mr. McLennan, is not the difficulty that the Home Secretary is quite incapable of keeping those people in prison who should be, and those things out of prison which shouldn't be?
Well, Mr. Speaker, I think that's as absurd a political point as was made by the Right Honourable Gentleman. Clearly, this is not a matter which can be held at the Home Secretary. This is a matter which occurred in the Foreign Office, and for which the Foreign Office and I personally, before the House this afternoon, take full responsibility, and cheap politics are no way to investigate this matter.